If you've been doing wireframing of SharePoint pages with users, you know how slow it can be. SharePoint's page editor just isn't the fastest interface in the world. That's something we've just come to accept. Until now, there's a new way to do wireframing and it's lightning fast. Let's get into it. Many times, you as the SharePoint admin will be working with users to build out a new site for them. They don't typically know what they want until they see it on the page. So traditionally what that means is you're building out a SharePoint page in the page editor, you're swapping things around, you're changing that kind of stuff, and getting feedback from the user, hopefully getting close to a final product. Otherwise, they say, no, this whole thing just doesn't look right, let's start over. That's where Figma comes in. Figma is a wireframing tool, except it goes way beyond wireframing. In this case, Microsoft has released a UI webkit with an initial set of web parts and other components. That means you're able to drop a representation of different web parts on a page without the usual required setup. The initial set of web parts they've released correspond to the company and organization news site in the SharePoint lookbook. That being said, not all web parts are in this tool right now, but they will be adding more as time goes on. The Figma interface is a little bit odd if you're not used to using that particular product or even wireframing tools in general. I'm new to this product myself, so let's just jump into this thing and see how it works. To get started, you're gonna go to figma.com/@Microsoft. There's also a link in my description below to go straight to this page. From here, you're going to locate the SharePoint Web UI Kit. So we're going to click on this. And on the right, you'll see an option to open in Figma. Now you will have to log into this, so I'll log in with my Google credentials. And now we're in. So just to orient yourself with what you're looking at. So there's some pages down here. There's a getting started page, which will take you to a few pages to get you familiar with what you're looking at in here. Now to actually start creating page designs, what you're going to want to do is go to the left and drag this bar down a little bit so that you can see more of what's on this left-hand side. You're going to go to templates. And here you're going to see a few different page layouts. Over on the far right, you'll see a completed page design, and you can start adding and customizing this. But what you really ought to do is start with this leftmost page to get familiar with how this is laid out. You'll see that you're able to specify all the different column widths from full width all the way down to a 3-column layout. There's an option for vertical columns, and then some instructions for adding content to the page. Further down, you're going to be able to see some example column layouts that you can copy and paste onto the middle section of this area, which is where the blank page templates are. So let's go look at those now. So here you'll see two different page layouts, one with no vertical section, and then the other one with a vertical section on the right. Let's start with the no vertical section layout and see what's on here. I'm going to do a control mouse wheel to zoom in, and you'll see there's a few different clickable areas, but if you start double clicking in here, you'll see that there are sections in here. And if you just hover with a mouse, it'll highlight those sections and you'll see what the column layout is for those. So to add a web part to one of these sections, we're going to go up to the left and click on the assets tab. And you'll see different web parts here and different configurations for them. So if we were to look at the hero web part, for example, we've got the layers option and the tiles option. If I just drag the tile onto here, then we've just added it to this template. Over on the right, you'll see some properties here, some properties specific to the hero web part. So we could change this from 1 tile down to 5 tiles, and we can drag this thing over, and now that's added. All of these different web parts are added in a similar way, and it really speeds up mocking up these pages. This is another wide column. I don't really need this, so I could just highlight this and hit the delete key. And now we're left with a 2-column layout. So if I wanted to add in a news web part below the hero, the list layout, and then a tile layout over on the right. And then there's some extra space at the top, so I'll just highlight this and hit delete. So the layout is a little bit weird. It's going to take a little getting used to, but it's definitely going to reduce the amount of time it takes to mock up a site and build one out with a user. Like I said, this can be done in an interactive call with them. You can do a screen share and start dragging and dropping things on here to get the look that that user wants on their site. So you may be asking yourself, how do you deploy this to a site? Well, you can't. It's unfortunate, but you still will have to build out this page by hand. So that may change in the future, because I know Power Apps does have the ability to import Figma templates, but for right now, you're stuck with manual building. What this does do is it will save you a lot of time, and that time is, you know, going through iterations and iterations with the user for what web parts they want, the order they want them in, the layout, the sections, all that kind of stuff. All that time is saved because you could just have an interactive session in Figma with this user. Just share your screen and work through this together. So you have a lot of time saving, not having to configure web parts over and over again, and instead you just have a fast interactive session with the user, finalize the design, and then you'll build out the page one time. I definitely think this is worth a try, and see how you like it. If you've used this before, if you've used Figma, let me know down below, what do you think of this tool? The point is, this reduces the amount of time you have to spend gathering requirements from the user of what they want on their site and what their pages should look like. Now, saving time is important to me, and I know it's important to you. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more content like this.